we are going to demonstrate how to remove a stud. We're gonna focus on cylinder studs here for a two-stroke motor, but like I said, this could be done in an exhaust manifold, intake manifold, doesn't matter. So a stud by definition means that there's threads on both sides of this bolt, and the idea of the stud is that it stays into the piece of equipment, and we're going to thread and unthread fasteners off of this for the future. So in this case, we have a cylinder head on here that we would torque and untorque multiple times, and we really don't want this thread coming out. So typically they're in there pretty dang tight with some Loctite, or they're even an oversized stud that the bottom threads that are going down here are larger and they grip in and dig into that cylinder stud. So we go ahead and heat these up if needed. I'm going to make an attempt here to do some cylinder stud removal without heat, and we'll just see how this works, okay? One of the oldest methods for removing a stud is to simply take two of the exact same size fasteners, and what we're going to do is we're going to butt these two up against each other, and we'll see if this will come out. Now, the other thing I want you to be careful of is I need to think about the way that I'm going to put force on this, because I don't want this cylinder to pop out of this vise. So there's going to be a little bit of testing as I do this. If possible, you can also do this. I'll show you a little trick here. Is I'm going to go ahead and get my bottom wrench down on here, okay? And you'll see why in a second here. Then I'm going to take my top one here, and this allows me, what I want to do is be able to go to having the closed end. Why do I want the closed end when possible?
It doesn't slip off.
Now what this allows me to do is I'm going to grab onto this bottom one here. I'm going to support this because I don't know if it's going to come flying out of here. And I can see the whole stud is turning. Can you guys see that?
Yep.
So this one didn't take any heat. That'll allow me to go ahead and get this out here. Now, the negative is that I can tell that it's taking enough force that I cannot loosen these two lock nuts right here, because I really need that gripping. What's happening is by turning this bottom one, it's hitting the top nut here, and that's so tight there that it's just taking the lesser path of force, and it's removing the stud. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be careful. Do I want to drop this stud into the cylinder?
No.
No, not at all. Could you take it, stuff a rag in here if you were concerned?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you could do that. Could you use a ratchet wrench on here if you wanted to?
Perfect.
Yeah. I would only do that if it was coming out nice and easy like this. Make sense? Okay. I'll go ahead and just do this to completion. And that is, still can't get that by hand. I have not pulled these out before. This is a first time on this cylinder. It's a mid-80s two-stroke Honda 250 cylinder. Okay.
Go ahead.
Now, before I'd want to put this back in, what would I want to do to the threads of the bolt and the threads of the cylinder? I would want to service them, right? So I would want to clean those up, dry them, but I'd want to run a tap, or preferably, anybody remember? A thread repair or a chaser down this, a thread chaser, just to clean those threads up, and then run a die along this and get it all good and back into shape. So now at this point, what you could do, if you needed to, let's say that this is just garbage, I could clamp this in a vise, or I could simply do something like this here, crack it loose that way, and now I could go ahead and take them off, because what I had in my drawer is I just had a whole bunch of different size of these nuts that were real common, and I just went ahead and kept them with my two-stroke stud removal tools in my own shop. Just had a box of these real common fasteners, because do you necessarily want to be looking for exhaust bolts? So the ones that you're doing over and over, it's good to just keep a supply of those handy. So for the installation, like I said, these would have just been left on here. I'll go ahead and just snug these up. We would go ahead and have this all cleaned and repaired. I would go back in here. I would repeat the process.
Loctite
is commonly required, like we talked about. And I just want to make a point here on something, is that sometimes these will just bottom out, but quite often they will have what they call an installed height.
Let me grab a caliper.
Do you use like a medium grade Loctite?
It'd be a red. Okay. Yeah, yep, you definitely would use a red on this. So more of a permanent that takes heat to take it off. Okay. So they would have an installed height, or the stud is long enough to where it just bottoms out. It's one or the other. Does that make sense? If you look here, you can see where one's been repaired, and you can see here how you've lost the meat of the stud right here, and it's just all bolt on there. So that might be that they just took a long 8mm by 125, that's what the thread pitch is on this particular fastener. Maybe they cut the head off and they just used the threads to try and bring this back into service. Can you guys also see that it's been helicoiled?
Yeah.
Can you see the repair on that? Just because this isn't as tall does not mean it's a problem. Sometimes you will have studs that are in at different heights to accommodate the cylinder head. So if a customer just brought you this and said, hey, put this on, you'd need the service manual, you'd need to know the heights, and ideally what you'd want is you just want to set the head on there, and then you'd want to see about how much exposed thread. Yeah, well over half an inch because you got the crust washer. Does that make sense?
Yep.
So typically that's just a way to look at that, and you can see how you could install that. I want to show you guys, we've also got a brand new tool here that's pretty cool. I haven't used this before. This is by Motion Pro. Pretty excited about this. I'm going to go ahead and loosen this up. And I'm going to take my cheat method off here. So, I like tools, like cool tools. This is by Motion Pro, and they're calling it a cylinder stud tool. So, what we have here is we have multiple different, this is a 6x1mm stud, real common on exhaust, some metric motorcycles, on intake and intake manifolds, 6x1. 8x125, and then the last one that I see here is a 10x125. What's neat about this tool is you can see here that inside it has the whatever correct threads of the stud that you're trying to install. And on the top side, it's got a little ball bearing. You guys see that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And what you're going to do is you're going to thread this on. And I can see there's some oil on here. We could take some grease and you take and set this ball on here. And then tighten up this Allen, which is going to lock the ball down against the stud. And you see how it's just turning it right in place?
Yeah.
Okay, so once this is tight, you grab your 17 or whatever this is and lock those two down, and then use your regular large size wrench to basically thread that into place to the installed height.
You can install and remove with that tool?
No, this is install only.
Okay.
This is installation only. Because what it's doing is it's that ball that I just took out is hitting the top of the stud, putting some pressure on there. So you're physically locking them down just like you're locking the two nuts. And then as you turn this, it's threading the stud in place. Okay, installation tool. So before I showed you guys kind of a cheat method on removal was the double nut, okay? Now, one of the other ways to do this, but typically ruins the stud, is this four-piece, this is for multiple sizes. What's interesting about this kit here is that it was identified as a metric stud removal kit. So you see here it's 12mm, 10mm, 8 and 6, and you'll see how it works here in a second. But the thing is, there's basically these ramps in here, and what's gonna happen is you're gonna see, and look at me, everybody look up here, as you fling this up against a stud, those ramps will grab on and lock themselves, okay? And what's cool about this will work for installation or removal. But the only way this tool works is you have to have them on a real estate where there's no threads. Okay, so watch what happens here. I'm 8mm, do you see how I go over the threads? And I'm not damaging that at all. The other thing is, if I were installing this, so when I flick this, do you see how it actually locked?
Yeah.
And I'm holding tension on it? As soon as I hold tension on here, now it'll keep threading, but I have to be really careful not to take the tool and dig into the cylinder head. So would you say that we need a lot of intention when using this tool?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Oh, man, absolutely. Or you could cause damage. If I just sat here, I'll go ahead and screw this up here, and I got all the way down here and I spun that socket around that head surface, I would ruin the cylinder. Okay, so we need to be careful. We have to be careful with how we use this tool. Now, the reverse of it is that I'll just get it to where it locks, and then I'll go ahead and watch how easy that pulls that stud out. Then take the tension off. My recommendation is to remove the tool. Now watch me up here. Just kind of wiggle that around, and then I come off and I don't ruin any of the threads. Because what's happening, if you look through the tool, if you guys look down through here, you'll see that we're gripping down here, and this is hovering over the studs. And due to the different sizes, we get, by having the right size on here, allows us to flick it over and grab it pretty easy, and the tool just works much better. Now the thing is, if you look at 8mm and you look at what the conversion is to a standard size fastener, this one kit will do all your standard studs as well. There's an in-between step that this will work for standard or metric, even though it's identified as a metric tool. This is not grabbing the metric threads. When they say 8mm, they just mean this diameter. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Does anybody know off the top of their head what the conversion is for 8mm? Well, let's do this. On that on the wall chart right behind you, I'll just convert it over here quick. 316 thousandths. That's over a quarter inch. So what is it? What's the fraction?
5/16.
Is 5/16 sound like a common fractional stud or bolt?
Yeah.
Right. What's the next size one? If it's not 5/16, what's the next one?
21/64.
Is there a 21/64 stud?
No.
No, right? It'd be quarter, 5/16, 3/8, half inch. So we have all these different ones here. So if we go to our 5/16, which is our 3.125, the next biggest one is 3/28, and what I say we were 3/19 or something.
Yeah,
but were we being precise?
No,
we were just getting in between. So the 8mm converted to fractional, the closest one is a 5/16. And the other thing about this chart is you'll notice here, the ones that are larger are your very common bolt sizes. 1/8 inch, 3/16, quarter, 5/16, 3/8. You don't go to the hardware store and find a 13/32 bolt. Would you agree with me that these in-between sizes, what they're really more referenced for is drill bits?
Yep.
Yeah, these are more drill sizes. So with this one chart, we can grab what we want. And then you guys have these also that even have the metric conversion all in one chart as well.